First of all, thank you so much for sharing a few moments with us to talk about our father. If you could share with us what you think my father's legacy is going to be.
You know, I think that what I think his legacy is one that that teaches people that regardless of your beginnings, that we all have a contribution to make. You know, when I look at my dad's life, you know, he didn't come from a rich family, never earned a lot of money, he was a farm worker. And normally people would think that somebody that comes from those backgrounds don't have much to offer society. And I think what my dad and what your dad, what they've showed us, is that regardless of our backgrounds, the position in life that we're born into, that we can all make a difference, right? You know, my dad was blessed to have people like Benny there. You know, I was mentioning to some of the folks earlier that you know, we're getting ready for another holiday season where we're going to be going across the country, and people are going to be lavishing all kinds of praise on my dad's legacy. And when I go, you know, of course as his son, of course I'm very appreciative of that. But I also know that my dad was always feeling comfortable receiving those kinds of personal recognition. And I think it was because he understood that his work would have not been possible if it wasn't for people like that. People that were there on their manning the picket lines, or when there was a wedding out there, he was there. Or if you needed to do security, he was there. And it was those soldiers that made that possible. So you know, I think the legacy is that Benny showed us that we can all make a difference. And I gotta believe that his continued legacy is the work that you see upon the continuing work of the union. It's a hard job, but the union continues. But, you know, it doesn't give up, it still pushes to represent workers, and it's working for immigration reform. Your dad's legacy is gonna live a value of competition, because that was part of the vision, broadcasting to immigrants. It lives with the affordable housing that we're doing nowadays, where we're providing decent, clean housing for poor working people. It's the educational services, the service learning program, the Looper project, it's the affordable housing, the self-help housing that we're doing down in the Rio Grande Valley. See, that's your dad's legacy. Those are the things that he built.
What do you think a loss like my father's life will mean, or how will it be felt in El Movimiento?
Well, you know, I think what happens is that, you know, time is a very powerful thing. It doesn't wait for anybody. It just moves on, you know. You know, here we are, 2009, and I find myself going to funerals for many of the old-timers.
More and more often. Pioneers.
Yeah, I do, right? People that I remember growing up around and looking at them and saying, man, these guys are tough guys, right? So I think what it does, right, is that it reminds us all that the torch will be passed from generation to generation. You know, the work we do today, we do it, you know, all the work that we do today isn't anything that we developed today. We're continuing on the foundation. We're building on the foundation that your dad laid for all of us. And so I think that you know, there's people that are working in the movement right now that didn't know your dad, but they're surely beneficiaries of his hard work. That's for sure.
And I guess my final question is, what is your most vivid memory of my father?
You know, I was thinking, you know, the thing that comes to mind would be, you know, your dad was always there. He was always there, right? I mean, just, there were certain things, right? Like the sun comes up every morning, your dad was always there, you know? And the thing about it is that I remember my dad, I talked to my dad one time, and we were actually watching football, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we were there, and he said, Mijo, you know, if you were a football player, what would you be? Probably wide receiver or quarterback, right? And my dad said, not maybe a fullback. My dad said, I like those guys that get there and mix it up, and they get knocked down and get up and they dust themselves off. They say, let's do it again, right? See, it kind of reminds me of your dad. Those are the guys that just never gave up, right? Mm-hmm. Get knocked down, they go, okay, let's go at it some more. And so I think of your dad like that. When I see your dad, I see my dad, right? Those old timers that are tough guys,
right,
that never give up, right? And so, you know, the what comes to mind is we would have the luncheons here. We've had a lot of people there, and we'd be doing events, and I'd see your dad over there, and I'd always wait for them. I always look forward to talking to your dad, and he was there every year. We'd go over and show the Lalo, how's it going? He was there to look at the Eagles, right? But I always remember your dad being there, right? And you know, the most recent thing was seeing him at the dinner, right? And a lot of times, people kind of crowd around and stuff, and I was always worried that I might not be able to see him and thank him, but he was always there.
Yeah, I was sharing that with Councilman Nowakowski a moment ago. A similar story, you know, that my dad was the guy that you could always count on to do the grunt work, to do the stuff that other people didn't like to do, to knock on the doors,
to do the work that's got to be done.
The pullback work,
yeah. It's true.
Well, we do appreciate you being here and taking time and you know, spending some moments
with us. You know, this is the least we could do, you know. Your dad was always there for my dad, right? This is the least, we're honored to be here.
Thank you so much. We're very humble. We appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Just in time.
Yeah.